Let's start our journey to Amritsar. You can go to Amritsar by Volvo bus service operated by HPTDC, which departs at 8 p.m. in the evening from Manali bus stand, which is just opposite to the Manali Mall. Volvo bus costs ₹1,500 and ordinary bus costs ₹500. But car journey is more comfortable as per my opinion. Though the car is costlier, which costs ₹12,500, but more comfortable and flexible. Buses are ideal for the solo travelers. So we will reach Amritsar by Manali to Mandi and Mandi to Amritsar via Palampur, Baijnath and Pathankot. So on the way, you can have your breakfast, lunch and evening tea break at Nitish Punjabi Dhaba. Also, you guys can directly come to Amritsar by road, train and air. Nearest international airport is Sri Guru Ram Das Ji International Airport, connected globally, which is just 11 kilometers away from city center Amritsar. Nearest railway station is the Amritsar Junction. Good afternoon guys, welcome to Punjab. This is on the way beautiful sunset at Pathankot. Pathankot has two sides. Half is at Himachal Pradesh and another half is at Punjab. So after some checkposts and toll tax, we are at Punjab side Pathankot. Next, it will take 3 to 4 hours to reach Amritsar. We will do our dinner at roadside KS Vaishnav Dhaba. After half an hour journey, you will reach Amritsar. It's better to take a hotel near Golden Temple such as Golden Lagoon Gin Hotel. Next day, being a hotel just beside of the Golden Temple, you can visit Golden Temple first, and it is our main priority to start the Amritsar tour with the blessings of Sri Guruji. As well, we all know more and less about the Golden Temple, but originally called as Sri Harminder Sahib or Darbar Sahib. This is Gurudwara located in the city of Amritsar. It is one of the most braver spiritual site of Sikhism. And this is the main reason anybody would visit the city of Amritsar. This is a calm and enchanting place for the peace of mind. Before entering the mandir, you must cover your head with handkerchief for men and dupatta for women. Also, you can buy the handkerchief from the outside market of the temple at the cost of rupees 20. There is a facility to keep your luggage and shoes at free. Then, you can go into the temple by soaking your feet into the small running stream on the ground so that you enter with clean feet inside. The fresh water makes the temple pleasant. The top of temple is covered with 750 kg gold. That is why it is called the Golden Temple. It is awesome. If you visit the temple at night time, the view of the temple is just 180 degrees opposite of the day view. It looks so elegant in blue, white and yellow light with beautiful reflection in the water. Next day, after visiting Golden Temple at morning, we are visiting the beautifully decorated Katra Ahuwalia Market near the Golden Temple. Here, you can buy variety of things like famous Fulkari Patiala cloth pieces for women, Mugaris, shirts and Nagada shoes and various stuff related to Sikhism. Replica of Golden Temple inside glass lid box and many more. Also, you can drink famous lassi from various shops here and eat kulfi ice creams at rupees 20. And the streets are awesome with beautifully decorated. We will go to the Jallianwala Bagh, which is just beside Golden Temple and Katra Market. The Jallianwala Bagh is a public garden where monstrous massacre happened here. Also known as the Amritsar Massacre, took place on 13th April 1919, where the troops of the British Indian Army under the command of Colonel Reginald Dyer fired rifles into a crowd of Baisakhi pilgrims who had gathered in Jallianwala Bagh. Troops first blocked the entry by a tank and locked the exit. On Dyer's order, his troops fired on the crowd for 10 minutes, directing their bullets directly towards them and the few open gates through which people were trying to flee. The British government released figures stating the 379 dead and 1,000 wounded. The other sources place that the number of dead at all was 1,000. The brutality stunned the entire nation, resulting in a wrenching loss of faith of the general public in the intentions of the United Kingdom. It's really so sad. This is the main memorial inside the garden. You can see the martyrs' well, the well in which people jump to escape the bullet. It has been preserved inside the park. It stands as the reminder of horrific that occurred here. You can also see the bullet holes in the wall within the Jallianwala Bagh garden. On the exit, there are museums preserved with various notes, letters, pictures and others. Photography inside the museum is not allowed. Jallianwala Bagh is open to public on all days, but the memorial is open between 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. in summers and 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. in winters. So, from the front of Jallianwala Bagh Memorial, Katra Market, you can catch an auto rickshaw to go to the Wagha border. Auto rickshaw costs Rs. 800 for full booking or Rs. 100 for per person on share basis. You can do lunch at the dhaba and you can reach the border before 4 p.m. not to miss the beating retreat ceremony at the Wagha border. The popular cuisines of Amritsar include tandoori kulchas, channa bhatura, multi-layered parathas, marmalat, puris, mutton tikka, Sikh kebab, barbecued chicken and fried fish among several others. There are a number of dessert and sweet options too that are available in Amritsar. From Garka Halwa and Balu Shahis to Pinnis, Amritsar present a wide array of lip-smacking delicacies. After lunch at 4 p.m. we are at the Wagha border. The beating retreat ceremony has started. It is a daily military practice that the security force of India means Border Security Force and Pakistan Rangers have jointly followed since 1959. Make sure you don't bring any camera or any types of bags. Ladies' handbags are also not allowed. Okay friends, do visit Amritsar and have a great journey. Thank you.